Just as I thought. With this setup, it's no wonder you had trouble dematerializing.
We're doing what we can to stabilize them. And these things are a great help.
Ah, yes, your droids.
They're not ours, Doctor. And they're not droids. Didn't Mr. Tetsuo mention?
Mention what, my dear?
They're time travelers too. As stranded as we are. We thought they were our ticket out of here, but whatever system they've used isn't compatible with our technology at all. And their ship is out of power. They call themselves Daleks.
Green things!
Hello there!
Have you heard of them, Doctor?
Sadly not, I'm sorry to say.
We have been informed of your expertise. We look forward to working with you.
Oh, delighted to make your acquaintance, dear fellow. Delighted.
Nice to see our guests getting along so well, isn't it, Antoine?
Yes, quite a picture.
With this time traveler's knowledge, we expect our work will be completed on schedule.
Very good news indeed.
And when were you planning on telling me that I wasn't the first time traveler your team had encountered, Mr. Tetsuo?
Business always requires discretion, Doctor. So far, these Daleks have helped us stabilize the damage, but getting us back home so far has eluded them.
With this primitive setup, I can't say that I'm surprised.
The power supply of this vessel is insufficient for successful dematerialization.
Ah, you noticed that as well, did you?
With you offering your services so reluctantly, you can hardly blame me for keeping my hand close to my chest. All that talk about your all-seeing, all-powerful race of time travelers. What an absurd notion.
I never said we were the only ones with the technology.
Yet here is a race you freely admit to never having heard of, Doctor. How have they evaded your people's notice?
I don't know. It's strange. I can't quite put my finger on it. Like, I should know.
I'll lead the Daleks here to get you up to speed, Doctor.
Our report on the last cycle of the operation is ready.
I'll take it to my quarters. Good day, Doctor.
Well, I suppose we had better get to work.
We are currently running a full power cycle of energies in order to equalize the dimensional fracturing. This will take 1 hour and 4 minutes to complete. You are welcome to observe.
So, that's what they're doing. Very ingenious.
Strange creatures, aren't they, Doctor?
Oh, they're much more than machines. You can tell by the way they move. I'd go so far as to say they had a living occupant.
That is correct.
Excellent hearing, too.
What you see of us is our travel machine. Without them, we could not survive.
They look like us originally.
Like us?
So they told me. A race of humanoids who became embroiled in a neutron war with a rival race on their home planet. The radiation levels increased and they started mutating.
Until they became dependent on the radiation itself, I take it. Fascinating.
After that, they renounced war and only lived to serve others. They don't want anyone else to make the same mistakes that they did. They devoted themselves to science and exploration.
It's a nice story, except for one thing.
What's that?
That device built into their right side is an energy weapon. If they are so peaceful, what do they need it for?
Smile for the camera.
Ready to make my report.
Pause. Hold that thought for a moment. I want to ask you a question.
Is the report no longer required?
In a moment. This man, the Doctor, can he get us home?
He has great knowledge of time travel.
What about his people? Should we be worried?
If they are as powerful as he indicated, logic dictates that they would already be here.
How true. When the work is complete, how accurate can we be about our return destination?
Your records indicate that this ship reached its original destination with 99.96% accuracy. At current operational levels, accuracy should only increase.
And if I wanted to change our destination?
That will have no effect on the accuracy of this vessel.
Then I have a task for you. But it must be secret. You understand? You mustn't tell a soul.
Proceed.
Before we leave, I want to change our destination. We would appear 10 years before we departed. Do you understand?
Affirmative.
I tried last time. Maybe that's why everything went wrong. But with your help, we will not fail. Do you want to know why?
That information has no bearing on your orders.
If only everyone was so trustworthy. I had one of the technicians help me before. He kept his mouth shut so far. I don't like the way he looks at me. Perhaps a little job for my new bodyguard on our return. Do you see that boy on the screen there? Do you know who that is?
Negative.
That is my son, Katsuhiro. 10 years before we left, he was bankrupt, finished. He could have asked me for help, but he was too proud. He took his own life.
He sacrificed himself?
Yes. I know, not exactly logical.
There are many logical reasons for self-destruction.
It was a challenge. He explained it all in his note. He thought I was wasting my time on these experiments, not giving his business enough support, that I would never succeed. If I ever would, why didn't I stop this happening? Well, now I shall. And he will forgive me. And we will both be rich.
You saved our vessel from the vortex. The Daleks will obey your instructions.
That's the circuit isolated. Now, let's see if it's up to scratch. You there, number two. Could you go over to that panel there and give me the readings, please? At 1 second intervals.
I obey. 174. 198. 252.
Good.
397. 509. 642.
Excellent. Just the increase we need. All stable at your end, number one.
No instability to report.
Wonderful. Now let's increase the power by 5% and go again. But do let me know if the readings top 1,000, won't you?
Good morning, Doctor.
Mifune-san, feeling more refreshed?
I am. Did you not sleep yourself?
I find it hard to relax when the universe is in danger of being ripped apart.
I pride myself on being able to sleep through anything. So, you are still playing with these strange metal men, huh?
They've turned out to be exceedingly helpful, as a matter of fact.
Someone has been scribbling on them. They have numbers on the sides of their head.
That was me. I was having a little trouble telling them apart. They don't appear to have names of their own. So, have you decided yet?
On what?
Do you stay here, or go home?
I have no home. Not anymore.
You'll take the job, then.
Tetsuo Dono has given me a chance to start over. If this is a dream, it is one from which I do not wish to awake.
If you're sure. But there may be no going back. You'll be entering a strange new world, full of things you won't understand.
I understand the war, Doctor. How to fight? How different can it be?
Who gave you that sword?
Antonasan. I have already killed several chairs.
Be careful with it, for my sake at least.
Tell me about their world, then. The future.
I have not visited myself, although I've read about the period. From what I can gather, Earth was shared between two peoples, with humans on one side and...
Doctor, good morning.
Good morning, Antoine.
You have been busy, I see. Any idea when we will be ready to launch?
As soon as we've completed these tests. And as soon as I'm convinced that we won't do any more harm to the fabric of space-time, than you've already caused.
Readings have exceeded 1,000.
Blast! I was afraid of that. Power it down for a moment. Perhaps if I had room to breathe, I would be able to concentrate on the job at hand and get you all home a great deal quicker. I can't continue with these interruptions. Dalek One, please escort this gentleman out of our workspace.
I do not understand.
Oh, we've been over this. You're Dalek One, you see, like the number on your dome.
Can he see his own number?
Good point. Well, it should be easy enough to remember, shouldn't it?
You've made your point, Doctor. I'll see myself out. Good day.
Now, where was I?
How many bandits would you say attacked you?
It is impossible to say for certain, sir. A great number.
They grow more dangerous by the day. Just this morning, my young apprentice found that his traveling companion, another samurai like ourselves, had been abducted in the night. I fear the attack cannot be long coming.
Another samurai, did you say?
Yes. He would have been a valuable asset.
So there are still just three of you to defend the entire village?
That is correct. You are welcome to stay here under our protection, of course. I'm sure we can find a roof over your head for the night. Please excuse me one moment.
You are an idiot, Ozu.
What have I done?
He has grown suspicious of your questions.
But Ichi, what does he mean about the missing samurai? We didn't kill one of them already, did we?
Shh! Here he comes.
I have sent my apprentice to find you shelter. But I would like to ask you some more questions about the men that attacked you.
Please, we have told you everything we know.
The leader of these bandits, Takashi. Did you see him there?
I could not say, sir.
He is an ugly brute, with a patch over one eye. He would have been giving the orders.
I wish I could recall.
Did he think I was just as blind as he, that we would not see through this subterfuge?
Ichi!
Pull out your sword, Ozu. He knows.
Just as I thought.
Very clever, old man. But it won't save your life.
Kitano Sensei!
Stay back!
Out of my way, rodent.
Ozu!
You are outnumbered, my son. Put down your sword.
Never.
Then prepare to die.
My uncle Takashi will make you pay for this. All of you. He'll burn this village to the ground and all of you in it.
Perhaps. But you will not live to see it. If they all fall so easily, they will not trouble us long.
Do not gloat, my young apprentice. When these two do not return, they will attack soon and in force. We must be ready.
Power at 800. 820. 843.
Good. Good.
897. Power holding.
It's working. Excellent. Good work, number one.
You have succeeded.
Yes. Power down, number three. We don't want to burn out.
I obey.
Not a bad piece of work, if I do say so myself, given what I had to work with. Like using a bicycle to get to the moon. In fact, it's exactly like the time I used a bicycle to get to the moon.
Shoulder that light to be flashing.
Oh, that. That just means my toast is done.
So, we can leave now?
Soon, yes. Number two, replicate what we just did to this engine to the other one. Exactly, mind you.
I obey.
What we need to do is disconnect this ship from the space-time surrounding it. Right now, the day we picked you up in is stuck to the ship like a seaweed. We need to remove it. So, we need two engines. One in the time loop itself, and one here. We'll activate them in tandem, and we're away. You understand?
Yes. No.
Good. I should probably program it to self-destruct as well. Wouldn't want to leave a working time machine in 16th century Japan, now would we? I've already left the TARDIS there, but that's not a problem because it's locked. At least, I think I locked the doors. What time is it? Coming up to sundown. We can't do it now. For one, the village is about to be attacked by bandits, and, well, they'll only get in the way. For another, the time loop doesn't appear to retain any non-living matter that wasn't there to begin with. If we introduce this engine at the wrong time, we might lose it. Dalek One, how long would it take to build one of these from scratch?
To refine the materials and construct such a device from the equipment available would take 13 days.
By which time, the universe could have been torn apart. So, we're waiting till morning. But then we only get one chance. It's not just getting these people home we have to worry about. Those people up there in the village right now, they're probably being massacred. If the time loop ends tomorrow, then what happens this time sticks. We have to make it right. No pressure at all, then. Did you follow all of that?
So you have succeeded.
Yes. Go and tell Mr. Tetsuo the good news, would you? And ask him what's for dinner.
He might have more beer. At once, Doctor.
Huh. Not a bad day's work, if I do say so myself. How's the engine coming along, number two?
Engine will be operational in 2 hours.
Excellent. Thank you. I couldn't have done all this without your crew, you know. Mr. Tetsuo has been exceedingly lucky in finding you.
We are glad to be of assistance.
Juliet! Juliet!
I'm here, Professor.
You gave me quite a start. Do you have it?
Yes. Does that mean...
I just heard. He's done it. The doctor's fixed the engines. We leave tomorrow.
We were meant to introduce the poison into his body over several weeks.
There isn't time for that now. You'll have to give him the full dose.
What about the autopsy?
It will only confirm what they already suspect. But by then, that bloodsucker will have his time machine, and we will have our money.
I don't know. There must be another way.
There isn't. I can't do this alone, you know that. I can change the coordinates, but we have to put Mr. Tetsuo out of the equation. And if we fail, I can't protect you. I'm sorry, but it's true. You know what they do to traitors.
Okay.
Stay strong. Not long now. I had better go. Tetsuo will be looking for me.
Good luck.
You too.
Okay, Juliet. You've come this far. Just a little further. Sorry, I didn't... I'm sorry. I'm just a little jumpy. What are you doing here?
I did not intend to startle you.
No, of course not. How long have you been... Did you have a message for me?
You intend to alter our destination.
A what? No, of course not. I don't know what you think you heard, but you must have misunderstood.
You are lying. It is not necessary.
No. I'm sorry.
Mr. Tetsuo is already planning to alter our destination. He is lying when he tells you his plans.
He is?
His heart rate alters when he attempts to deceive you. It is logical that you should plot against him.
Then you won't... Won't tell him?
No. If this mission is to be a success, then he should be eliminated.
I'm going to poison him. With this. He should be dead by morning. Everyone will be under suspicion. Lister and I are going to hijack the ship in the confusion. You said you can tell when someone is lying, didn't you?
Correct.
He isn't planning to betray me. Is he? Professor Lister? You heard us talking. I have to be sure.
He is not planning to betray you.
Good. I trust him. It's just... This is a dangerous game we're playing. I had to be sure.
You have affection for him.
No. Well, yes, I suppose. He recruited me for this. He could have picked anyone. Can you tell? I mean, does he feel the same way about me?
No.
Of course. You can't tell things like that. Stupid of me.
He does not feel affection for you.
In that village is the swine who murdered my nephew. I sent him there this afternoon to offer them one last chance. Surrender, and we would have let them walk away. We would have merely taken their rice, but spared their lives. And what did they do with this act of kindness? They murdered Ichi. an unarmed man, a boy. Now, it is our turn to be cruel. We will take this village. I want no prisoners. We will show these fools what it means to stand in our way. Who's with me? Charge!
Thank you. It was nothing, really. I think Juliet here deserves just as much praise for this meal. Your own recipe, you say?
Sort of. My family's recipe, anyway.
I am surprised you went into science with culinary skills such as these.
I didn't realize how gifted my mother was until I took that scholarship to Earth. My parents were housekeepers for those devout. I barely even met another human I wasn't related to until I went to university. Then I realized the rest of the universe didn't eat like this.
You were fortunate enough to escape the devout, I'll say that.
I suppose they did pay for my education, though.
No, I mean before. I mean, yes, fortunate for us, that is, that you were able to escape and share this marvelous recipe. Mm.
Oh. Is there any more?
Help yourself. Mm.
Yes, you'll need your strength for this morning, Mifune-san. Mm.
My thoughts exactly. Mm.
Are you giving my bodyguard orders, Doctor?
This is the only way it will work, Mr. Tetsuo. Someone has to be there to guard the engine. We can't risk it being tampered with in any way. There are bandits running amok up there, not to mention inquisitive locals. Who better than Mifune-san?
That's not the point. He works for me now.
Fine. You ask him then.
Why can't you do it, Doctor?
Surely I'm needed in the main control room. If something went wrong, you'd need me there.
Can't the Daleks handle everything at that end?
I would hope so, but I wouldn't be so sure if something unforeseen was to happen.
Such as?
Well, if I knew, it wouldn't be unforeseen now, would it?
So this wouldn't be a ruse to make sure the samurai doesn't return with us?
Exactly my fear, Professor.
I'll make sure he has ample time to return to the ship. His is more of a diplomatic role. He can explain our situations in ways they'll understand. He's perfect.
When they see my new sword, I don't think anyone will be arguing with me.
Hm. Perhaps not, Mifune-san. You better leave that behind.
Not take my sword? Not take my sword? But I have only just got it. Tatsuo-dono, tell him I can't take my sword.
Let him keep his new toy.
Ha! Mr. Tetsuo, with all due respect...
Stop! I cannot take any more arguing. I think I will retire for the night. Until tomorrow.
What is the matter with him?
He is older than he likes to let on.
Still? You heard him? I get to keep my sword.
Lights down, lights down. Water. I said water. Oh, it's you. You startled me. Did I request a progress report?
You are unwell.
Yes. Just a little under the weather. Probably just stress or something.
You are dying.
Don't be ridiculous. I had the full medical before we left. I've never been healthier.
You have ingested a poison. Your immune system is trying to combat it. You will expire in 2 hours, 35 minutes.
What? Poison? Who has done this?
If you do not ingest an antidote in the next 30 minutes, your condition will be irreversible.
Who did this? Tell me.
The poison was added to your last meal.
Juliet?
Affirmative. She and Professor Lister are attempting to assassinate you.
I knew it. Scheming coward. They won't get away with this. You must help me kill them. They won't suspect you. You said you would obey my instructions.
I want them dead.
Do you wish me to synthesize an antidote?
What? Yes. Yes, do it. They'll pay for this.
Huh. It looks like daylight up there. No time like the present.
How do we scale the well? I cannot see a rope. Some thief must have stolen it.
Yes, that little problem troubled me as well. Fortunately, Antoine let me in on an ability of these Daleks that surprised me, quite frankly. Is the engine secure, number three?
Affirmative.
If you would be so kind as to grab onto our metal friend, Mufune-san.
Grab on? Why?
Like this.
This had better not be a joke.
Now, hold on tight.
Elevate.
Not so fast, not so fast.
Halt!
We have stopped.
The opening above is too narrow.
Yes, I did think it was getting a little cramped.
Engaging weapons!
No, wait!
Run! Someone get help! There is something coming out of the well!
I am covered in dust! I can barely see!
Well, I'd rather think we scared the life out of him. This could take some explaining. Well, at least the engine made it in one piece. I do wish you had given us a bit more warning. You say that thing is only for self-defense.
Just a moment. Mr. Tetsuo.
Good morning, Juliet.
You're feeling better.
Yes. Juliet, could we have a word?
Of course.
How well do you know Professor Lister?
Not that well. We only met a few months before the mission.
Can you think of any reason why he would want me out of the way?
Out of the way? In what sense?
Juliet, last night I was poisoned. If I hadn't been able to synthesize an antidote, I'd be dead. I suspect Professor Lister may have been behind it. I had his accounts looked into. He received several large payments leading up to the mission.
An inheritance, perhaps? I think he mentioned an aunt passing away.
That could be the explanation. Or it could be a payoff made to look like an inheritance. If he is behind the attempt on my life, then I must know for sure. I need you to follow him. Find out if his royalties lie elsewhere. Can you do that for me?
I'll try.
What is that thing?
Look at them, scurrying like mice.
Whereas you, of course, took the Daleks in your stride.
Halt!
Good day. You must be the famous samurai Katano Sensei.
Who are you?
Do not be alarmed. We mean you no harm.
Mufune?
Ah, Komurakan. We meet again.
This is the drunkard you were telling me about.
Drunkard?
Yes, Sensei. I thought he had been captured by the bandits.
It was not the bandits. But this kind old wizard has been my diversion. He does not mean to cause you any harm, but he and his only friend, this strange metallic creature that he forged because he had no friends of his own.
Excellent work, Mufune-san.
They have an important message for you, which you will now relay.
I will. I mean, thank you, Mufune-san. I will indeed.
What is this foolery?
I am, as my friend so kindly put it, a magician. Allow me to demonstrate. Would you mind elevating just for a moment?
Elevation unnecessary.
I knew that, but that was an order.
Elevate.
It is magic, Sensei.
How is this done?
I come here not to impress you with simple tricks, but to ask for your help. These woods are full of evil spirits, worse than bandits. In order to exorcise them, I need this engine, this talisman of mine, erected here. My metal companion and Mufune-san will protect it, but they need your help. No harm can come to it.
Is he telling the truth, Mufune?
He is.
We still have Takashi and his bandits to worry about.
This thing could kill 1,000 bandits. Go and look at the well.
Kitano-sensei, the fate of the world, nay, the universe, rests on your shoulders.
We will do as you ask, sorcerer.
Jolly good. Mifune-san, you stay here with the Dalek until you get the signal. Don't let anything happen to the engine. I'd better get back to the control room. And keep an eye on it, won't you? There's still something about them I don't like.
Yes, Dr. Sama.
Sensei, this all seems very strange.
I know, my young apprentice. This could still be a trick, although I struggle to think how it was achieved. Still, we'll watch them carefully.
Yes, Sensei.
Hey! Hey! It was you I was talking to before, wasn't it?
Affirmative!
I think he's onto us. Mr. Tetsuo, I mean. We're going to need your help. Follow me.
Good news, everyone. The engine is in position. Everyone, please report to your stations. Is my toast done yet?
Everything is now in place. Commence the next phase. I obey.
Not in the control room, Professor?
Mr. Tetsuo, you're looking well. Sorry you took me by surprise. I was just about to head down. I believe we're good to go.
Yes, we are. Good to go. But where are we going?
How do you mean?
Not to the development lab of one of my rivals, I hope.
Why would you? I mean, surely you don't think...
I know, Professor. I know everything. Juliet...
You have to protect me from her. She's dangerous. She recruited me when she arrived at the university, told me they'd kill my family if I didn't go along.
Don't bother. Right now, I've got her convinced that I think you're in on it alone. She'll give up your contacts, so long as we shift the blame off her, and I'll know exactly who wants me dead.
But I can give you that information. That is, she told me you can't let her do this to me.
Don't worry. She'll be dead as well, if that's any consolation. Killing.
Exterminate!
You know, considering we're 70,000 years in the past, and you don't officially exist, I do believe that may even have been legal.
New orders received. Next stage commencing. All humans are to be exterminated!
That's the spirit. Let's go find that girl. See if we can't make her talk.
All humans will be exterminated! Exterminated!
You don't mean... No. No!
Exterminate all humans!
The power is building steadily. Excellent.
Overheat approaching on coil 3. Drop power, Dalek 2. Dalek 2? Hello? Oi! I said drop the power, Dalek 2!
Has it worked?
I knew it. Bloody thing's rusted. Dalek 3, take over Dalek 2, will ya? It's not responding.
Has this happened before?
No, not before now. Fine tantrum go totally tonto on us. Do we abort? I mean, where's Mr. Tetsuo?
Wait, it's moving again.
Finally! Thank you, I'm almost obliged. Dalek 2, copy, please.
Exterminate all humans.
You what?
Exterminate all humans!
Hey? That doesn't sound right. Everyone get back!
Oh, sod it.
Exterminate!
Everybody get out of here! Now listen, I don't know what's happened, but...
Don't just stand there talking to them, you fool! Run!
Well, perhaps under the circumstances...
Door close. Close!
Hello, sir.
Juliet, get away from that thing. They are trying to kill us all.
I'm sorry about this. It's nothing personal. I've never killed anyone before. I thought he was just getting information. But it's you or us, don't you see? I don't have a choice.
Shut up! That doesn't matter now.
These things are trying to wipe us out!
Why would they do that?
How should I know? Just get away from it!
Can you make it quick?
No! You want information? Take it all!
Exterminate!
Let's get out of here! We have to find Lister.
Human designated, Lister eliminated.
What?
All humans will be exterminated.
No!
Exterminate! Exterminate!
What do they want? There must be some way to stop them.
I don't think so. In here, quick! Wait here. I will be right back.
Where are you going?
6 hostiles remain. 4 hostiles remain. 3 hostiles remain.
All hostiles must be eliminated.
Our Emperor will arrive. All hail the Emperor of the Daleks!
There must be a way to stop them. Think, Doctor. Think! Oh no, they found me. Nothing to worry about yet. They'll still have to cut through that door first. That gives me, what, a minute? Now look! I don't know what happened, but we can talk about this. There must be something you want. I just want to know why. All those innocent people, why?
All hail the Emperor of the Daleks!
I'm sorry?
All hail the Emperor of the Daleks!
Do you mean me?
All hail the Emperor of the Daleks! All hail the Emperor of the Daleks!
All hail the Emperor